nonprofits fighting gun violence in Pennsylvania may have a harder time accessing state grants this year. And a mid-state city looks to make a statement in support of the LGBTQ community. Welcome to The Morning Agenda, WITF's daily news podcast, where the only agenda is you. A good morning to you. It's Tuesday, August 8th, and this is being recorded at 9:17 a.m. I'm your host, Tim Lambert, as we take this daily trip around the region's top stories. Let's get started. Pennsylvania's newly approved state budget has less money for gun violence prevention than it did a year ago. Sammy Kaola is with our partner WHYY in Philadelphia and has the details.
In 2022, the Gun Violence Intervention and Prevention Program got $105 million, $30 million from the state and $75 million from the federal American Rescue Plan. Shapiro proposed putting in $105 million from state money this year, but the budget he signed allocates just $40 million. This money supports community violence prevention work, hospital-based programs, and victim services.
Nonprofits are calling on the governor to find other ways to invest in these programs. While state police are investigating that fatal crash involving a tour bus along Interstate 81 that caused it to roll onto its side in Lower Paxton Township Sunday night, my colleague Ben Wasserstein has the latest on what we know.
Three passengers were pronounced dead at the scene, state police said. 28 others were taken to Hershey Medical Center. One adult was in critical condition. Two others, including a child, were in serious condition. Matthew Oshiafi, a passenger, says he lost consciousness and woke up to the chaos.
I saw people moving left and right, shouting, my wife is dead, my son is dead, this, that. I was like, yo. Then I saw them on the floor, lifeless.
Oshiafi escaped with minor injuries.
Now, the bus was headed to Cincinnati from New York. Some passengers were cleared at the hospital and taken to Chambers Hill Fire Department, where the Red Cross set up a shelter. Later, they boarded another bus to complete their trip. The city of York could bar licensed therapists from practicing conversion therapy. That's an attempt to change a person's sexual orientation away from those of the same gender. My colleague Gabriela Martinez reports the larger goal is to promote a safer environment for the city's LGBTQ community.
The measure would mean the City Human Relations Commission could investigate if someone alleged a mental health professional was practicing conversion therapy. Conversion therapy has been discredited by the American Psychiatric Association and the American Medical Association. Claire Toomey, executive director of York's Human Relations Commission, says she's not heard complaints of conversion therapy being practiced in the city. This could be in part because people are afraid to come forward and out themselves in the process. So a city ban could help people feel safer, she says.
Now becomes invitational for people to come forward and say, oh, there is a place I can go and submit a complaint, right? It's setting the tone for creating safe space for folks who wouldn't ordinarily feel comfortable coming because they don't know us.
One note, the ordinance would not apply to religious organizations that practice conversion therapy. Just want to bring your attention to the availability of The Morning Agenda on YouTube now. It's at the WITF channel. You can subscribe there. If you like what you hear each and every day and you want to get us through the regular channels where you find all your favorite podcasts, you can certainly do that. And also give us a rating and let us know what you think in a review. So I was looking for a few stories to put on your radar this morning, and that means going through about a dozen news sites from across Pennsylvania, trying to find stories that cover issues that could impact you or your community in the future, and also some stories that just need to be on your radar. So here's what you need to know. A 17-year-old who was shot and killed early Sunday morning by Lancaster City Police was armed with a ghost gun. That's according to the Lancaster County District Attorney's Office. Ghost guns are firearms that do not have serial numbers and can be assembled from kits ordered online. Our sister newsroom, LNP Lancaster Online, reports DA Heather Adams' office says when police arrived to a report of a burglary in progress, Darren Shaw pointed a handgun with an extended magazine at officers who then shot him. Other officers who arrived administered first aid, but Shaw later died at Lancaster General Hospital. Now, LNP has filed a request with the DA for police officer body camera footage. The burglary was reported just after midnight, but Shaw's mother says she was shocked at the police account, adding she doubts it was a burglary because officers told her video from the scene does not show him leaving the residence with stolen property. She did not clarify whether she was referring to video from a body camera or security camera. A mid-state attorney and real estate developer is the latest Pennsylvanian to be charged for allegedly assaulting police officers during the January 6th attack on the U.S. Capitol. Lowell Gates of Mechanicsburg is president and CEO of Linlow Properties. Penn Live reports prosecutors say he traveled to Washington, D.C., joined the riot in front of the Capitol building, and threw objects at a group of law enforcement officers before assaulting them with a flagpole. Now, Gates has admitted he was there, but claims he did not retaliate after he was struck with a rubber ball and contaminated with pepper spray amid the riots. But police body camera footage shows Gates lunging at officers with his flagpole as though it were a spear. He struck them at least three times, according to prosecutors. Gates has been charged with assaulting, resisting, or impeding officers using a dangerous weapon and obstruction of law enforcement during civil disorder. Just a reminder that at least 89 Pennsylvanians have been charged for their involvement in the Capitol attack to try to keep former President Donald Trump in power, even though he lost the 2020 election. That number is the third most in the country, behind only Florida and Texas. And state police are launching a pilot program where its more than 4,600 troopers will eventually don body-worn cameras. We go back to Penn Live for this one, which reports the cameras were issued 2 weeks ago at the Carlisle Barracks for a 60-day field test. The law enforcement agency will use what is learned from the effort to fine-tune its policies and procedures and later roll them out to its 87 stations across the Commonwealth. Advocates say the cameras serve as impartial observers to police-citizen interactions. Well, my friend, it is that time to wind down the morning agenda for this Tuesday, August 8th. So I just want to know, what is the one song you are singing in your head today? Reach out to me on Twitter. Let me know about it. I'm at tlambert895. You can also email me, tim_lambert@witf.org. I'm calling an audible today because today is my 14th wedding anniversary to my lovely wife, Amy. I'm going with the song we played for our first dance, Ben Harper and the Innocent Criminals, In the Colors. If you haven't heard that one before, you can check it out on the Morning Agenda Song of the Day, August 2023 playlist that is available on Spotify. And that is going to do it for the Morning Agenda. It's a daily news podcast from WITF where the only agenda is you. And I hope you never forget that. I'm your host, Tim Lambert. Thank you so much for listening. I appreciate you joining us each and every day. Be well, have a great one, and we'll talk again tomorrow.